Continuum 2025 has just been released, and with that comes a series of ML tools designed to assist and streamline your post-production process. One of those tools, BCC Plus License Plate ML, is designed to see all of the license plates in your shot, blur them, and track them across the length of the footage. Let's see how we can work with this, as well as deal with complicated situations. Okay, I'm here inside of Premiere Pro with the clip that we want to work with. And as these cars approach the middle of the frame, we can start to see the license plate on both sides of the highway. What I want to be able to do is obscure them all together. So I'm going to head over to my effects tab, and under BCC Match Move, you're going to find our new BCC Plus License Plate ML. With my clip selected, I'm going to double click this and see that it has now blurred out the license plate with several cars that are close and visible to the camera. In order to see this clearly, we can head over to Effect Controls. And there is an option under the view so we can see the license plate overlay, which identifies everything that it currently sees, all those license plates there, tracking them as they approach close to the camera. Now we do want to note that there is a license plate in the middle of the divider that we don't want to have included in this operation, and we'll take care of that in just a second. I'm going to switch the overlay back to output, and let's head to the effects editor, which is handy for all BCC Plus effects, giving you options to a series of presets and for you to discover different ways that you can obscure the license plate, either using mosaic and even a colored tint of your choice. All these options for the different types of obscuration effects are in the parameters available in the host or inside the effects editor where we're working. In this specific case, I'm not so fond of the tint, so I'm going to get rid of that yellow tint. And I'm going to introduce a little bit of a mosaic look and also add a mosaic scramble, which has the mosaic move on the license plate surface. Now, obviously, you might be able to see here the one thing that we don't want to have tracked, which is this sign. I don't mind showing this license plate here at the side of the highway. And this is where we can use Pixel Chooser, and that comes into play. Simply, we're going to activate it and choose a shape to make sure that it doesn't actually track and blur out this area. So I'll press Apply to head back to my host. And right here where it says Mocha Mask and Track, let's go inside of that, where we'll find Pixel Chooser. I'll turn it on, and let's just view the matte mask, which will just appear as white across the entire frame. I'm going to head to the mask section, and we'll choose a rectangle shape, which happens to be quite large. Let's go to the scale mask, just bring that down. I'm just gauging here roughly what the size of the sign is. If I select this from the top of the effect, I do have the option to use the on-screen controls. Might be better to do so with the view mask matte option turned off. Now, right now, the mask is set to only show the mosaic pattern over this selected area. But what I'm going to do is invert the mask to get what I actually want. So no blur mosaic pattern in this section and just over all of the cars. And let's now just watch this full frame to see the end result of all of those tracked license plates on our footage. Done in no time. Now, I'm just going to hop over to another sequence to show another example here, where we have two license plates within the shot. But most importantly, you'll just notice that the license plate becomes obscured temporarily from the man walking in front of the camera. I want to show that this is no problem for license plate ML. I'll just double click to add the license plate ML to the shot. And I want you to see that as the man starts to cross, you'll notice that it will turn off the effect temporarily and then turn it back on right after the man moves away from the foreground. Let's also just see this shot full frame. Now, last but not least, here's an example where we have a moving camera, not to mention a couple subjects in the frame that I don't want to show because I don't have the rights to it. So let me just play a few seconds of this footage. I'm going to stop playback, press escape, and first off, introduced in Continuum 2024.5, we have Witness Protection ML. I'll just drag and drop that to the clip, and draw your attention. I'm going to set this to 200%. And just notice how it picks up on the subject here on the bike. I'm going to fit this to the window again. And not only does it do that, but you'll notice that subjects that faces appear in the car and might be visible to camera as it approaches, it also picks up on that. This tool works in exactly the same way as license plate ML and also in tandem with it, which we'll see here in a second. Let's go back to our effects tab and let's do a search for license plate ML. And under the match move section, I will apply that to the clip here in my timeline. I'll now notice that as I play back this clip, closer to the end, it somehow gets confused that this is a license plate here on the sidewalk, which we don't want. So because this shot is moving, rather than use pixel chooser in this case, I'm going to use Mocha masking, which is integrated inside of it in order to make sure this area doesn't get picked up on. So let's head to effect controls and I'll open up my Mocha mask and track section. I'm going to click on Mocha mask. And what we're going to do is track that area right around here on the sidewalk, identifying it as a place that we don't want to bring up any blips. Now that I have this tracked area identified, I'll choose how I'm going to track this. In fact, I'm just going to track translation, scale, and rotation. And in the Essentials workspace, I'm going to track this backward. I'll head back to the frame where I added the mask and just track this forward. Now that this is done, I'll close out of Mocha, press save, and notice that we have the same thing that we had before, which is the blurred area is what is kept in frame while all of our license plates are no longer obscured. We want the opposite. So we'll twirl down the Pixel Choose a Mocha section. I'll head into Mask, which is set to Mocha Spline, and let's invert that to get what we want. And let's render this out now and look at this full screen. And here's the end result with Witness Protection ML and License Plate ML combined together. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to subscribe and check us out at boriseffects.com, where you can sign up for a free trial and take Continuum for a spin.